Monster Rancher 2, released back in 1999, is one of my favorite games on the PS1. And honestly, I still have yet to find another game that gives me the same feeling. But as a kid, it was also frustrating that I never finished it. So around 6 years ago, I tried again, and thanks to Toro guides readily available on the internet, I managed what I only dreamt when I was a kid, raising monsters to be this strong. This was so satisfying that I raised tons of them and made a YouTube video of them kicking names and taking ass. People began to ask how I did it, and with the DX version's release, I feel it's about time I answer. So let's do it. Playing the remaster is gonna be an experience for me though, so bear with me. So I'm starting from a new game here. I hope Coltia looks even cuter. And the music's remastered. Pretty good. Here's the welcoming guy. He looks... the same? Huh. Well, whatever. So of course, first thing you do is enter your breeder name. Cool. And yeah, show me my assistant already. Oh, it's as cute as ever. But also unchanged. Did I fail to flip the remaster switch or something? No? Moving on. Now, raising a monster to be this strong actually requires planning. A lot of it. And also math, but I'll try to make it simple. First thing you do is pick a breed you want to raise. So go to the shrine and disc stone away. And I gotta say, this feature is really cool. We can just generate random discs. Makes getting monsters a lot easier. And I choose you! Brown doggy? You cute little pixely image, you. Yeah, why are the monster cards still so pixelated? Second step, take note of the order of their starting stats from highest to lowest. And done. Step 3 is going to be picking... parents? Guess we're gonna be combining them to make this monster. Take note, you're gonna wanna look at the guide for this. No wonder I sucked at this game as a kid. Guess you'll want parents with stat growths that will make matching the stat order of the baby easier. So I pick Blue Wolf, and I want to name you Kid Poo. How do I can't put spaces in the name? This was not the case in the PS1 version, I assure you. Guess I'll settle with a hyphen. Kid-Poo, sounds neat, right? Anyway, we're going to raise these two parents. Let's start with a blue dog, because this is going to be the main pick when it comes time to combine. Ah, we're back at the ranch, which looks also the same. Okay, what the f***? Is this really a remaster? Ranch activities are rather simple though. We just want our monster to get strong and live a long life. We do this with proper exercise and sleep, proper nutrition and supplementation, essential oils, and some recreational stuff. I mean, seriously, why else is it so effective at relieving stress? These are the various schedules I use when on the ranch. You follow these and I guarantee your monster will live long. Proven monster science. Except if your monster doesn't like tablets, oh yeah, I forgot to mention, avoid those. Ranching takes time though, so it's really awesome that they included the fast forward feature. What a godsend this is. Feel free to sneak some battles in there if you need cash too. They're always fun. Okay, can the game slow down? I can't appreciate the match this way. Why in poo perfect hell does the fast forward feature stay on in the match? I have to go to the menu to manually turn it off every time? Seriously. Now, by far the only real source of shortened lifespans are errant trees. Especially when this happens, oh f***. Unfortunately, there's no other way to learn new sick battle moves, or we're gonna have to suck it up. And we want to do this with the main parent so that the child can inherit some of them. Ultimately, the goal is to raise both monsters so that they have the same order of stats as the eventual child, but also as high as we can get them. So, like this. But, I did mention we have to do math, and this is why. We have to take into account the stat growths of the parents themselves and convert the stats that they have. If this sounds like a pain, that's because it is. Which is why I encourage you to check out the calculator in legendcup.com or watch this other video that more thoroughly explains the whole combining process. Once we're done with the parents, here they are, it's time to combine. Note that when this low resolution faced guy says this, then you know you've done it right. Now all you need is good RNG. Yes, got it in one. Thou shall be named...
Barklord. A wolf with the ability to summon blizzards, shoot lightning, and spit ice cubes.
Depending on how strong the parents were, the child will also have enhanced stats right off the bat. Not the best I've done, but it'll do. It also inherited some moves, so less errantries for this guy. Well, shit. Good thing I saved, huh? As I was saying, once you get... No. Reset. There we go, god damn it. Step blah. That's it. From here, you raise your monster to be as strong as possible. Oh, and you may also want to look up how to get gold and silver peaches, and when to feed them to your beast. They help a lot. Something I didn't know of when I was a kid, of course. There's also more rigorous training schedules out there, like the no rest one, but what I've shown works fine for me. Easy, right? No? Exactly. And this I do not miss about the game. Their hidden mechanics that are very punishing to your monster's lifespan. And I think the devs knew it too. These were toned down in newer Monster Rancher games. But unless you read up a comprehensive guide, you probably never get past S rank. And while I'm on this topic of critiquing the game, I want to comment on the remaster too. Again, I have to mention, I love this game. But I already played it to exhaustion in making the battle exhibition video, so I'm also kind of sick of it. But it's a reality that the original release is pretty much dead, seeing as you can't get cool monsters without utilizing a dead optical disc format. So it might have taken 21 years, but I still want to thank Koei Tecmo for making this available to a wider audience with this damn near perfect port. Yes, I said port, not remaster. Honestly, when someone commented that I should get this, I was legit excited to play the game with a fresh new look. And so far, the only graphical touch-up they did are the tournament banners and the menus. That spells super lazy. Unfathomably so. The best thing I like about this is the music and sounds, which were remastered at least. They sound fantastic, by the way. But even these aren't perfect. Listen to the remaster. Now listen to the original game. Why in hell does the battle music loop so poorly? It is so jarring! And it irritated me so much that I fixed it myself. Man, this game was supposed to be my chill for the holidays, but all I got was the same grind I did back then, with little to nothing new to look at. I'm at my limit now. I don't want to continue. Barklord, I know we just qualified for the Major 4, and you have about 3 more years in you, but this is where I stop. Thanks for watching anyway.